An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies, and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky, for he saw the riders coming hard and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-i-oh! Faces gaunt, their eyes were blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught 'em yet. 'Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky, all the horses snorting fire as they ride on, hear their cry. Rider sloped on by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell riding on our range, then cowboy, change your ways. If they are with us, you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-i-oh!
Somebody new, it always winds up feeling more like a job interview. My mama used to wonder if she'd ever meet someone who wouldn't find out about me and then turn around and run. I met the man I call my dad when I was 5 years old. Took my mom out to a movie, and for once I got to go. A few months later I remember lying there in bed. I overheard him pop the question, and I prayed that she'd say yes. And then all of a sudden, oh, it seemed so strange to me how we went. Something's missing to family. Looking back, all I can say all the things he did for me. Cause I hope I'm at least half the dad that he didn't have to be. I met the girl that's now my wife about 3 years ago. We had the perfect marriage, but we wanted something more. And now here I stand surrounded by our family and friends, crowded round the nursery window as they bring the baby in. And now all of a sudden, oh, it seems so strange to me how we've gone from something's missing to family. Looking through the glass, I think about the man that's standing next to me. And I hope I'm at least half the dad that he didn't have to be. Looking back, all I can say about all the things he did for me is I hope I'm at least half the dad that he didn't have to be. Yeah, I hope I'm at least half the dad that he didn't have to be. Cause he didn't have to be. You know he didn't have to be.
Just about 90, he lived a long life. A bad hip and arthritis kept him up every night. So we took to a mountain on Saturday morning, knew that this was the day that he'd be reborn. He was tracking a grizzly, there was sign everywhere. Knew he didn't stand a chance, but he didn't seem to care. He was gonna go down in one hell of a fight. So he lit a cigar and he gathered his mind. When that bear stood up out of the cave he was in, most men would hightail, but he stood there and grinned. Got off one single shot, and it must have been scary. He's gone, but he left a cool obituary. All they found was his billfold and an old Stetson hat, half a cigar and a Rocky Mountain map. His 50 cal Hawking he took everywhere, even to his last fight with an old grizzly bear. Stood up out of the cave he was in, most men would hightail, but he stood there and grinned. Got off one single shot, and scary. He's gone, but he left a cool obituary. Found a note in his jacket, tossed off to the side. Said his best friend was killed when he was 75 by a dark grizzly bear that weighed 600 pounds. The same one that lay dead next to him on the ground. When that bear stood up out of the cave he was in, most men would hightail, but he stood there and grinned. Got off one single shot, and it must have been scary. He's gone, but he left